The epistle lesson for the fourth Sunday of Advent in year A seems, at least at first, to be out of place. It is the introduction to Paul's letter to the Romans. And as we know from reading Paul's letters, these opening sentences are usually kind of boilerplate. They contain the usual formalities and pleasantries one says at the beginning of a letter before addressing the subject at hand. So what do these formalities and pleasantries have to do with Advent? Well, let's find out together. Hello, I'm Stuart Baskin, pastor of First Presbyterian Church of Tyler, Texas, and this is your daily devotional for Wednesday, December 22nd, 2021. In a formal letter we would send, the letter would begin with a couple of headings, our name and address, and the name and address of the recipient. Then we'd date the letter, and maybe even include a line indicating the subject of the letter. Only then would we write, "Dear so-and-so." Paul's letters were very similar, though the actual content would be a little different from ours. He begins with his own name, followed by a description of who he is. Then he indicates who the recipient is. Finally, instead of "Dear so-and-so," he always writes something like, "Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ." We call this the apostolic greeting, and many of us continue to use it. For example, I use it at the beginning of the announcements in morning worship every week, all of which is mildly interesting, but still begs the question, what does this have to do with Advent? Let's read the passage first, and then let's see what we make of it. Paul, a servant of Jesus Christ, called to be an apostle, set apart for the gospel of God, which he promised beforehand through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures, the gospel concerning his son, who was descended from David according to the flesh, and was declared to be Son of God with power according to the Spirit of holiness by resurrection from the dead, Jesus Christ our Lord, through whom we have received grace and apostleship to bring about the obedience of faith among all the Gentiles for the sake of his name, including yourselves, who were called to belong to Jesus Christ. To all God's beloved in Rome, who are called to be saints, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. So I think you can see the usual pattern here. Paul introduces himself, identifies his recipients, and gives the usual "Dear so-and-so" greeting. But notice how long he takes to identify himself. Not simply Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, but much more than that. And it's in his self-identification that the Advent themes come to the fore. In particular, the Advent theme for the fourth Sunday of Advent is in the phrase, "the gospel of God, which he promised beforehand through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures, the gospel concerning his son, who was descended from David according to the flesh, and was declared to be Son of God." Once again, as we discussed yesterday, we so often think that the emphasis here is on the virgin birth of Christ, which is important, but it's really more about a couple of other things. First, it's about the fulfillment of God's promises. And in particular, it's about the promise of a descendant of King David who will rule over God's kingdom forever. It means that God is preparing to make his rule over all things finally and completely manifest in human history. Second, it's about our response in faith to this promise. Do we reject the promise? Or do we receive it with joy and with gratitude? And finally, as we see at the end of this section, it's about God bringing the Gentiles, including us, into the fold. Once outsiders to the promise, we are now included through Christ. In other words, the scope of God's promised rule is universal in nature. If Advent is about preparation and penitence, Paul reminds us what we are preparing for and what our response of faith should be. Tomorrow, we take up the gospel reading for year B in the lectionary cycle, once again in a text concerning the announcement of Christ's birth. But for now, may God continue to bless you and keep you in all that you do this day and in all the days ahead.